here with the attic, and we really feel like the Lord brought us here because we were training up kids to do the work of the ministry. But what happened is we saw that it was really hard to get them out of the four walls, and so we all just kind of like to stay in that cozy, loving, warm and fuzzy group. And so we realized that, you know, we needed to really just reach out in our community. So we prayed about, we asked the Lord to show us where he wanted us to go, and he really brought us here, and we found favor with the managers and all the people here. So it's been amazing, and we just love the kids, and they look forward to this. And we're actually someone that we're connected with is going to be starting like a sort of like a house church, or maybe we should call it an apartment church.
They accepted the invitation pretty well, so we're expecting a big turnout for our first Green Meadows Body of Christ gathering.
Get a call in the street, now they're ringing my phone. I shake my head, say I'm busy cause the message is on. They only see me when they want me for the struggles they hold. Maybe it's the fact that I ain't smoking no more.
Put your hands up, wave your hands in the air if you wanna get crumped out. Put your hands out, shake your caboose and pop your collar if you wanna get.
Your name is power.
If you go through Jesus, because what he does is he cleans you up and he makes you right before God. He has a free gift and it's called eternal life. So when you establish your relationship with God and you come up to that bridge and you say, Jesus, I want to know God as my person. I want a personal relationship with God. I want to pray and be able to talk to God. Jesus says, not only am I going to give you that, but I'm also going to give you eternal life. I want to know that if I die today, I would have everlasting life.
Praise to the King of Kings.